For decades, we've been told fluoride is the cornerstone of good dental health. Dentists and health professionals have long advocated for its use, emphasizing its role in preventing cavities and strengthening enamel. It's in our toothpaste, mouthwash, and even our drinking water. Fluoride has become a ubiquitous part of our daily routines, seamlessly integrated into our lives. This belief, instilled in us from a young age, has led many to accept water fluoridation as a safe and effective public health measure. Parents teach their children to brush with fluoride toothpaste, and communities trust that their water supply is fortified for their benefit. But what if this long-held belief is not as ironclad as we thought? Recent studies and emerging research have begun to challenge the conventional wisdom surrounding fluoride. What if the evidence supporting widespread fluoridation is not as robust as we've been led to believe? Some researchers argue that the benefits may not be as significant as once thought, and potential risks could be overlooked. These are the questions raised by a landmark review that has sent ripples through the medical community. The review calls for a re-examination of the data and a more nuanced understanding of fluoride's role in public health. The Cochrane Collaboration, a globally renowned independent network of researchers, conducted a comprehensive review of existing studies on water fluoridation. Cochrane reviews are considered the gold standard in healthcare research, known for their rigorous methodology and unbiased assessments. This particular review, published in 2021, meticulously analyzed data to determine the true effectiveness of adding fluoride to community water supplies. The findings were surprising, to say the least, and challenged the long-standing consensus on fluoride's benefits. The Cochrane review found that while there is some evidence to suggest fluoride may help prevent cavities in children, the effect is actually quite small. The data indicates only a marginal reduction in cavity rates, which raises questions about the overall efficacy of fluoride in dental health. Moreover, the quality of the evidence itself was deemed to be low to very low, highlighting the need for further research. Many of the studies reviewed had methodological flaws or were outdated, making it difficult to draw definitive conclusions. The review also uncovered a dearth of reliable information on the potential harms of fluoride exposure, particularly in adults and at higher levels. This gap in knowledge is concerning as it leaves many questions unanswered about the safety of long-term fluoride use. This lack of clarity raises concerns about the long-term safety of widespread water fluoridation. Public health officials and communities are left to weigh the potential benefits against the unknown risks, making it a contentious issue that requires more comprehensive and high-quality research to resolve. While fluoride is considered beneficial in small doses, helping to prevent tooth decay and strengthen enamel, excessive exposure has been linked to certain health issues, raising concerns among health professionals and researchers. One concern is dental fluorosis, which is most commonly seen in children who consume too much fluoride during the years when their teeth are developing. This condition causes white streaks or stains on teeth. And in more severe cases, it can lead to brown discoloration and surface irregularities. These changes can occur with prolonged exposure to high fluoride levels, often from multiple sources such as drinking water, toothpaste, and dietary supplements. There are also concerns about the potential impacts of fluoride on bone health and thyroid function, with some studies suggesting a link to bone fractures and thyroid disorders. However, more research is needed in these areas to fully understand the long-term effects and establish safe exposure levels. It's important to note that these risks are typically associated with excessive fluoride intake, far above the levels found in most public water supplies. The levels found in optimally fluoridated water are considered safe and effective for preventing tooth decay, according to health authorities. What do you think? Is fluoride right for you and your family? Is there enough evidence for or against it? Will you change your fluoride habits? Let us know in the comments below. Also, like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more health updates. Keep smiling, and we'll see you next time.